How can something as beautiful as this be dying? A plague is ruining the land, but the Tree of Life still stands. Question is, for how long? End is coming to the new world. The tribes stand divided, in need of someone strong enough to unite them, or bring them all down. This is a story with an unusual beginning. So, let's expect an unusual end. Welcome to BIOMUTANT. Encode your DNA. Define your genetic structure. Choose a genetic resilience. Choose your first style. Pick your main color. Choose your detail color. Pick a class. Mercenary. Deadeye. Commando. Psyfreak. Saboteur. Sentinel. Saboteur. Saboteur chosen. Sounds good. Here's somebody with a troubled past, drawn into the spotlight of a story that's already begun. We're already at a crossroads. Choosing a path in life is that fork in the road where you make a choice or simply stop living. But for you, it's not only a crossroad, but a choice, a reflection of your ki, the primal energy that flows through everything.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm the dark side of you, your inner voice to be precise, an echo of the balance and consequence of your actions as you move forward.
So glad you realize who you really are. Let's keep to the bright and better path moving on.
You can't contradict yourself like that. You made the right choice to begin with. Why would you change your mind?
Because you can't deny what's deep within your heart. Sometimes a thought is just a thought. In the end, it's the way you act that counts.
But remember, this is just the beginning of the end. Eventually, it'll be my way or the highway.
Right is always right. Stories of death and the bodies left behind, a reminder that we're at the mercy of nature and the one that preys on others. Do you remember the beast that shattered your family? Or did you choose to forget? You turned your back on our world and got lost in your own. Meanwhile, the predator only grew stronger. This is not the time nor place to end this story. This time, it was best to run and live to fight another day. Let us hope you're ready for it when it comes. Predator isn't the only threat. The wildlife started to mutate when the end of days began and the tree of life started to die. The oil sludge is everywhere. To most, it only means death. But some have adapted to the new environment and changed with it. Evolution has its ways. Low on health. Oh, that helps work the kinks out. Who needs a weapon? That's a good find. Look, an emergency box from the Once Was. A rare sight. Pipe looks weak. The claw bar should come in handy. Whoa! It's time to find a way out of this place. No, really, I mean it. The Morks produce biomatter in their multi-organ that they shed under distress. Globs that affect the cellular coding strands of any living being when absorbed, including you. Knock them out. Thank you. chop it up. Hand up, further you go. Toxinol built vessels called arcs to save themselves from the impending doom. But was it too late? It is only from the flight logs of the single arc they left behind that we know other arcs traveled through the sky and beyond. It seems those that came before us never lost hope in finding a new home for their kind. Just a few moves left. Make them count. There are few records of the chain of events that led to the big apocalypse eons ago, but it's clear the world wasn't prepared for how recklessly the Toxinol Corporation would make its mark on the world. Their rare earth mining and nuclear industries generated tons of waste, and without consideration for the future, they dumped it all in landfills until they ran out of space. That's when they made the big mistake. They began dumping the toxic waste in the surf just off the coast instead, assuming that it would sink and decay with time. And they were right. But no one was prepared for what was about to unfold. Once in the surf, the radiation interfered with the genetics of the wildlife and created bizarre mutations in their offspring. It had an inconceivable impact on biodiversity and the entire ecosystem. The world as they knew it crumbled as nature retaliated. It would never be the same again, and what remained of it became ours. Of spark metal going pew pew is never a good thing. It's coming from behind that door. A warning label. The box looks like a potential brain melt. It's going to take a bit of puzzling to short circuit the door. There you go. The wheeled one is outnumbered. You'd better help him out. In the face. Every little bit helps. That's the last of them. Let's talk to the wheeled one before backup arrives.
Cosata ghetto.
He wants to thank you for taking his side against the scavengers. He sounds familiar. You just can't figure out why. He presents himself as out of date. He knows he's way overdue, but he hasn't given up. He doesn't seem surprised that you don't recognize him. You were just a child back then, the night everything changed. There have been rumors of a one-eyed Ronin seen outside the Great Wall, and he's happy to see it's true. The legend of the one-eyed child that grew up as an outcast is old and sad. The child could have been anyone, but the evil it had fled had left a mark. A facial scar to remember the past. It's a scar you're covering under that eye patch, isn't it? But he would have recognized you anyways. You look exactly like your Muma. There's no doubt you're the child, and that what Looper Lupin did to your village, your Muma and Popsy, was the beginning of the end. He says it has taken you a long time to bring the past back up to the present, to find your way back, but he's grateful you have. It was after the attack that the unity fell apart. Your Muma's disciples divided and formed tribes as a reaction to the blight that had fallen upon the land. After the old village was destroyed and you disappeared, a struggle between the families erupted, and over time, the disciples turned against each other. Had it not been for the Tree of Life, no one would have survived. He hopes you at least remember the tree. Asks if you were tired, as it's a bit of a hike here from the village. He wonders if your Mooma knows you are here. You're such a good child, so you probably did. Even the young forget. He understands why you came all the way out here, to see them, the potato people. The potato people, or Nonno, are a wonder, somehow interlinked with this little tree here, fueling its source of life. Magic? He claims it's just the force of life, the existence of energy, powering and connecting all things living, like the Nonno. The Nonno prefer to hide in glitter grass. He says you should get over there and ruffle it. See if you can make one come out of hiding. You found one. You should be proud. They don't come out for everyone. The Nonno's key energy is just what the Pensai needs to complete its cycle and grow into a tree of life. The small tree you saw up there where you met will eventually grow into a tree of life and start giving back to nature. It'll be the heart of the land. You'll need to support the tree for a long time to come. The only way it'll grow tall is with the burst of ki released from the Nonno as they become one with the tree. You'll need a net to catch the Nonno, and he wants you to use his, but asks you to be gentle. The Nonno are sensitive beings, an embodiment of ki, the primal energy. You handle that net like you've never done anything else. He's impressed. He's grateful for all the help he can get. There's lots of Nonno out there that need to be guided to the roots of the Pensai tree. They're hiding in the glitter grass that mostly grows deep inside damp caves, where they draw mineral from the natural rock. One day, he hopes the tree will have grown tall enough to sustain the world. But today, your focus is getting this one to become one with the tree.
Oh,
Now that you've seen the Nonno's connection with the tree with your own eyes, you have no reason to doubt. From this day on, he'll make nurturing the Pensai into a tree of life, a life goal, not only for our village's sake, but for all of us, everyone. One day, the land won't be as peaceful. Not even your Mooma will be able to protect us. You can already see the effects from how reckless those before us acted, and unless something changes, we're doomed. The land won't survive the side effects of the old world's industrial advances. He says you'd better hurry back to the village before your Mooma comes looking for you. You did good here today. No, she's got lots on her mind and needs rest after the raid last night on the Lupin camp with her disciples. Wonders if they let the Predator family live or not. He lost you there for a while, but no memory is alone. It's part of a trail you can follow. He says he remembers every single day he devoted to growing the Tree of Life, but now he's afraid it might be in vain. The tree started to die when the end of days began, and it wasn't long after that that the World Eaters arrived.
Mpa, wherefore?
The genetic evolution that occurred after the apocalypse that Toxinol Corporation inflicted on the land set the World Eater's DNA into overdrive. His friend Gizmo is working on a Mecton and needs help defeating the Jumbo Puff at the end of the West Route. Wiz is still repairing his octopod to confront the Merkpuff that dwells deep down under the surface at the end of the Northwest Route. Nocco has tamed the Majut and is preparing to take on the Hoofpuff at the end of the East Route. Finally, Goop is almost done with the Goo Glide, a machine able to ride the waves of the surf all the way out to the Porky Puff at the end of the route to the southeast. Out of Date says his friends are gearing up to stop the World Eaters. There's one at the end of each route. The road ahead won't be easy, but he's counting on your support. His friends aren't strong enough to end this on their own. He wants you to understand that you'll all die if the tree isn't saved. His friends have prepared something specific for each World Eater. The Mecton, the Octopod, the Majut, and the Goo Glide are almost ready to ride. Regardless, you'll meet again once you've played your part in the tribe war and the situation with the World Eaters. You're getting the hang of it. Quickest way out is through the roof where they came in, and the rope looks strong enough to climb. Know that the Tree of Life is dying. Its days are numbered. Without help, it can't endure the environmental change and assault from the World Eaters. A signpost maps it out for the cartographically challenged. Let's see. The World Eater that chewed off out-of-date's leg. You'll need a hat trick to bring that down. The World Eaters have made their marks on our world over time. That's not the first nor the last village it'll leave in its wake. Look, a survivor. Glad to see someone made it out alive. He's heard the stories about the terror inflicted by the World Eaters to other enclaves, but never expected one to come all the way here. He worries there won't be much left to save if this continues, even if the Tree of Life survives the attack. He doesn't know what your connection is to this place, but something tells him you've stayed true to your heart. Anyway, he needs help and says it's by your actions you'll be judged, not by your intentions. He's grateful for that. You still seem to have a spark of light in you.
What's there to like about light? It hurts to look at.
Not as much as it hurts to look at you.
Always making this personal.
And you're always trying to pretend it's not.
There's out of date again. He must have missed something important. Out of date knows you'll make a better stand against the World Eaters with the support of a tribe, and there's two nearby. The Jatni tribe is likely to be your primary choice as they seek to become omnipresent and, most importantly, feared. Regardless of who you choose, it won't be easy, as the conflict between the tribes is worse than ever, teetering on the brink of war. The Myriad's conviction to stop the World Eaters began when the Leviathans rose from the depths of the surf. Siding with the Myriad's movement for wholeness in a fragmented world might seem like the logical thing to do, but is it the right thing? One thing's certain, though. Destiny arrives all the same. The Jagni tribe only ever had one conviction: to bring balance to the world by wiping out the weak. They believe a cleansing is necessary to restore the world and want to let the World Eaters bring down the Tree of Life. But siding with Jagni isn't necessarily a bad thing. Fate will find a way.
Mpa, wherefore, where?
Out of Date says someone needs to break the stalemate and shift the balance of power to either Jagni's or Myriad's side.
Falu alu hero fofo umba bagua papamu.
He believes the tribe Sifus, Jagni especially, will listen to you and expects you to pay at least one of them a visit and play your part.
Oloi go bopawek, mpa, wherefore, where?
He believes you share Jagni's view on the world. Regardless, Jagni would welcome someone that had helped them against the Myriad tribe. He'll be waiting for you beneath the Tree of Life if you lose track of what you need to do.
The water.
Regardless, you'll meet again once you've played your part in the tribe war and the situation with the World Eaters. Another fork in the road. It's either the tunnel or the motor bridge. What'll it be? It's unusual that natural tunnels like this still exist. Most of them got flooded. Punch time! Lethal weapons. Thank you. A mercy, maybe. This area was beautiful before the tribe war began. Look at it now. It's a war zone. That's the Myriad Tribe's fortress. Will they be friends or foe? You should head up there. That way you'll know. Let's see. It's a beaten path to that door. If you go there, you'd better make an entrance. Says they're wary of strangers. They're at war. Wonders why the Sifu would want to see you, but he'll let you in and give it a try. The Myriad tribe act on understanding of the greater good and a code of honor. They believe uniting the tribes is the only way to restore the peace. The Sifu is convinced that defeating the World Eaters and saving the Tree of Life is the only way to make the world a better place. He welcomes you to the Myriad Fort and introduces himself as the tribe's Sifu. But he was hoping you'd show up. The news of a vigilante Ronin on crusade crossing the Great Wall through the crack in Bunker 101 has preceded you. He heard you took out of date side against the scavengers in Bunker 101. It seems you believe in helping your next, and that's something you have in common. He's convinced you've returned for a reason, and is glad you chose to come here. There's something about your spirit that sparks memories of you as a kidling. He can still sense you're kind-hearted. The Sifu says sometimes one memory can make another come to life. He hasn't thought about your Mooma for ages, even though she taught him a lot. He was one of the original Wang Fu disciples. Your Mooma invented Wang Fu. Originally, it consisted of unarmed combat and the six weapons: the boomerang, the shuriken, the bow, the staff, the nunchuk, and the hook and chain. The Sifu says it's time to set the past aside, at least for now. Unrest is sweeping the land, and there are rivals in all directions. Myriad wants unity between the tribes. Their goal is understanding of the greater good and establishing a code of honor. Says there has to be some dark so that light can prove its purity above it, and promises this will happen if you help them unite the tribes, defeat the World Eaters, and save the Tree of Life. He could only hope for you to do that, and is thankful you know what's right. That's a sign of strength. The Sifu was waiting for something to tip the balance in their favor, and with you by their side, he's confident you can unite the other tribes. The one you should coerce first is the Jagni tribe. The Myriad were placed here to fulfill a certain purpose, chosen to unite the tribes and take control of their destiny. The tribes need a firm hand guiding them into the future. Their kin have run out of options and found themselves backed into a corner. Even those who desire peace have been forced to prepare for war. You need to take the struggle to the enemy, or the enemy will bring it to you. When survival is threatened, there's no other option left but war. He wants you to focus. These are the new rival outposts your tribe needs to take control of. He says you'll regret not being on their side. The only way you'll learn their secrets, Wong Fu and the tribe weapon now, is if you defeat him. And that will never happen. Even though you don't share their values, they hope you'll lead with mercy. The outcome of this war is up to you. Tells you not to be afraid. Your fate cannot be taken from you. Claim the rival outposts and earn the right to wield the tribe weapon. Once you've dealt with the rival's outposts, you'll challenge their Sifu to unite their tribe with yours and let your kin share land again. You were all part of the same tribe once, but without your Muma there as a guide, the disciples turned on each other and formed their own tribes. Seeing you brings back his memories of the old village. Myriad wants unity between the tribes. Their goal is understanding of the greater good and establishing a code of honor. He remembers your kind and unselfish soul, and can sense you still have it in you, the will to do good. Anyway, the memories you make with your family are strong, and can sometimes come to life. Passing the old village on your way to the first rival outpost might help. Even though it's now a different place from a different time, it is a place that'll make you remember.